What's going on? I'm Kevin Hart. Right now, you're watching season 3 of Cold as Balls. Oh, shit.
Yes, sir.
How are you, sir?
Half of me.
Happy.
What's going on?
Charles Oakley. Oh, yes. Put your robot on. Okay. Going yes. To the top. Oh, what did I call you? Was it the enforcer?
Force. Oak tree.
Oak tree.
Just get out of the way.
Full-fledged lunatic. That's what they should have called you. Ooh. Lunatic Oak is what they should have called you. Ah,
Thank you.
That's because you can't feel your knees no more.
Oh, no, good knees. No surgery. Can't hurt concrete.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to an all-new episode of Cold as Balls. I'm your host, Kevin Hart. And I got a legend with me today.
Thank you, sir.
I got Charles Oakley with me today. First of all, Oak, you look great, man.
Yeah, well,
you haven't fallen off, you know, like a lot of your peers.
Well,
a lot of your peers is that looking like duffel bags.
Well, a lot of guys say, hey, they work in 12, 15 years of the league, now they can sit back and enjoy themselves, but I think life still go on.
Let's talk you. Let's talk history, man. Let's talk the game of basketball, the way it was played back then compared to the way it was played now.
It was more physical body back then.
Okay.
You know, you had to build your body for the moment. You score your defense, you play defense, and you're a hustle guy, you hustle. Now, you watch teams, everybody wants to be a three-point shooter.
Mm-hmm.
That wouldn't work back in the 80s and 90s.
You think the game is softer today?
That's what they want.
When you say they want, what do you mean? Are you talking about the
fans? Global.
Okay, okay.
Commission, whoever else.
Got you. If you played today, would you shoot three?
Oh, I mean, I shot at 33-34% when I played. Mm-hmm. It was coming in the tail end of my career. But yeah, I mean, I was stretched for.
You know, I know that you're still around your legends. You know, you got relationships with the greats. You, Jordan, you know. Patrick, if you guys are together and you're sitting down at the table, it's a conversation pretty much, we would bust all that.
We get into it, but they don't try because everybody said, well, the older guys hating on the younger guys. Not hating, it's legends.
You don't feel like you're in it?
I mean, I think I played my game to my ability, mm-hmm. but I made people respect me. It wasn't about I had to get 20 every night. And then on the floor, you're going to feel me.
There's only a certain amount of people that can relate to that.
First of all, I know who you're playing with. I play with Mike. I know I won't get no shots.
Because Mike is a gunner. Pass the ball, Mike.
Well, Mike is Mike.
God damn.
I didn't mind sacrificing my body for the better of the team.
Uh-huh. Give me your top five versions of what you do.
Let's take it down a step, man.
Yeah.
We doing a lot of talk. Let's see how this ice feels.
Yeah, you know what?
Ah!
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Yeah.
All right, well, you just let me know how it feel.
It feel good.
You know,
but my top five of my type of guys' attitude, you know, I like Dennis Rodman. As a matter of fact, I seen him the other night in New York. I was there, LT. So he come up, he said, you know, he came in to shake my hand, so he shook LT hand. You know, he's a hardworking guy. You know, he bring a lot to the game. Ben Wallace,
Dennis Rodman. I'll go you. I'll definitely say Lambert. You gotta put him in there.
I ain't think he was a dirty player.
I don't think he was a dirty player. I don't think you're a dirty player. I think the reason why the word dirty gets thrown into it is because of the image and the bravado that's going with with your attitude towards the game.
I ain't never heard no one say I was a dirty player. I just play hard.
No, I heard that you'll fuck somebody up.
No doubt.
They say over smack the shit.
I did that once they did something wrong.
Yeah.
And once you do something wrong with me, out of line, I'm gonna give it to you.
Open hand.
Whatever.
I know you and Chuck have had some legendary battles there.
They gonna get the ball 20 times, 25 times a game. I might get the ball 10. So my thing is, don't let them get their 30 point. Make them get 18 and 16, you know?
Mm-hmm. Toughest player you played against?
Biggest, Shaq. Toughest, I ain't gonna say tough.
Nobody? You're not gonna get Karl Malone? You're not gonna get that?
I ain't giving it to him.
That country got that.
He cried too much.
Man. Breaking news. Mailman was a crier.
Yeah, he cried.
Crying mailman. Where you at with Patrick? You guys still close?
I'm kind of mad at Patrick.
Why? What's going on with you and Patrick?
No, just what happened to New York. He never spoke up for me.
Really?
Yeah. He had 4 or 5 chances to speak up for me. Mm-hmm. And I had his back for the whole 10 years. And I mean, he texts me, you know, every now and then, but I deserve more than a text.
You're big on loyalty.
Have some balls off the court.
Yeah.
A lot of guys don't have balls off the court.
I want to talk about the layup.
Oh, the finger roll against Indiana?
Finger roll against Indiana.
That happens. Some stars get breaks.
Mm-hmm.
And I think one thing about he was consistent in New York. He stayed out of trouble, didn't do a lot. But when he missed that layup.
No, that was tough.
It's like missing a free throw.
Well, you're 7'12". You shouldn't finger roll the ball anyway.
Yeah, you're right.
You should have dunked the goddamn basketball. I'm the guy that always say what you did.
Yeah.
I don't know why they're not just dunking the goddamn ball. All right, you know what? Come on. We wasted time. Let's go, Chuck.
Ah.
Let's go. All the way down. Get the stool out. Black hand, you back there? Be careful, Blackhead. Oak will smack the shit out you. That's what he's known for.
Yeah.
He's just a hand. Ain't nobody back there. It's just a hand.
You know, when I played, they had these in the locker room.
Yeah.
I never got in one.
Really?
This is my first time.
Why did you never get in tub? You never got hurt?
I never got hurt.
So you saying you're not human is what you're saying?
I got hurt, but back in our era, you had to play hurt.
Okay.
Pull a hamstring, groin, fingers broke. Not like now. They take 2 months off that.
Yeah, you say these guys today are b****s.
Yeah.
Remember me?
Well, we heard...
Oak called all the players b****s today.
No, we heard some other guys call players that too.
The difference in today is the luxury. The way that these guys are taking care of their bodies now, it's coming from science and s***.
Some games, I just eat like turkey sandwiches and a bag of chips. I don't like hotel food, so I just go to a Burger King, get a double burger and some French fries. Swear to God.
Here's a story that I heard. I want to know if this is accurate, man. Is it true? They say MJ used to come and he would take y'all out the night before the game, get y'all steak dinner, try to get y'all good drunk, and then show up the next day, and that was another reason why he was just cooking.
No.
Rumors.
Some of that's different. Maybe me and MJ get together, not everybody else.
Okay.
Me and MJ would get together, we'll sit around, play Tonk, Spades. What got me close to him, real close, is one time we was in Seattle, MJ twisted his leg in practice. And so that night we got together, about 5 guys went to dinner. So all the guys were like, yeah, MJ, yeah, you know, you should pick up the check. MJ like, y'all get a check just like me.
Yeah.
They got kind of mad because MJ wouldn't take the check. Guy wanted to fight him. I was like, man, you can't fight the man.
You stepped in there.
I stepped in.
You and Fort.
We've
now,
been
did
tight
you,
ever since
did
then.
Did you step in, bop, bop, or did you step in with words? Or was
I
it a
stepped
beep,
in.
Beep?
We just got tight, though. He took a liking to me.
I mean, look, we're sitting here, we're talking about enforcers, right? Yeah. And I mean, the word enforcer is now a word because of the way that you enforce. So I felt it was only right to give us our own enforcers today.
Okay.
Give your enforcer. Daryl! Yeah, Daryl. Okay, stand right there, Daryl. Show him so you can see what he's doing. Yeah. Daryl, act like you smacking somebody. Yeah. Mother.
Okay. You gotta do it quick. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nah, that's 2 foot back. You gotta go, yeah.
Yeah.
You gotta come hard though. Look. Yeah. A little harder. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want you, Daryl. You his enforcer. So you gonna stand next to you gonna stand next to Oak after seeing the way that you would enforce. Daryl, have you ever smacked anybody? I mean, come on, man. Maybe you're not right-handed. Did you do it with the wrong hand? Are you left-handed? That was bad. Come on, Bam. This is my enforcer. Bam, Bam!
Ah!
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, look at this guy. Yeah. Look at that.
Ah!
Hey, Bam, let me see your smack. How would you smack somebody? Bitch, if I got to... What?
Okay.
I said get my money, bitch.
No, huh?
Bitch.
Like the burger.
Get my money. Bam, bam. Come in my corner. You're my enforcer.
You got some weight behind you.
Yeah. So let me tell you the job of an enforcer. You make sure the star don't get hurt. You hear me? So basically, I'm about to say a bunch of stuff, and that means it's your job. It's your job to make sure that he don't do nothing to me. If he come, that means you got to come with the thunder. All that stuff you was just doing, you got to do it to him. Get ready, because I may smack this motherfucker right here on coldest balls. You understand what I'm saying, Bam? Because sometimes, Oak, I just don't give a f***.
No.
I'm going to start off by saying, f*** you, man. That's right. Go ahead. I ain't scared of s***. Man, where the light? Our production lights are gone, Bam. Everything went. God damn. How tall are you? It really went to shit when he stood up, man. What? You're not 7 feet? Where were you at, Daryl? You could have jumped on his back with that stupid ass smack that you put on display. I can't wait till this go viral so you can see what you look like. Stupid.
Are you gonna get down here with me? Get low. Get low.
And tell
you. The song's like, get low.
Easy. Done.
Get low.
Done.
Come on, get on out of there.
Yeah, no. Oak said I'm
going. Come on, get low.
Yep. Okay.
I got some questions to ask you.
Okay, I'm listening.
How many seasons did I play?
13.
You're 6 off, sir.
Oh, shit. No pushback today. Thank you, man. All right.
Hey, Daryl, whatever you do, double mine.
You better do it. He said double it. Smack that box
job
off your head.
Good job. What pick was I?
I gotta get this right. Okay. Reason why I gotta get this right, because the last thing we want is to get smacked. And that's the good thing about having a group. So if I get smacked, we get smacked. You at pick number 13.
Wow. I went top
six.
I went top 10.
Seven is what it was. I remember it was eight.
No.
It was. I thought it was nine, wasn't it? Where was we at?
Nine. Yes.
Yeah, that's what I said. He said double it, Daryl. You're going to get your mustache knocked off your lip. Enough of this fast questions, okay? What I want is to have an enforcer, and what I want to do is enforce. The last thing I'm going to do is be afraid on my show, on my show. This is cold as balls, and right now I'm just that. I'm cold, and I got balls. And bam, what we're going to do is put our enforcing to the test. So, Charles, I meant it when I said it. F*** you. Oh, oh, wait a minute. Give me a second. Bam. God damn. Oh my God, hold on. Where the f did Bam go? Hey, I wanna talk to you, man. What? Yeah,
what you say?
Well, listen, you cook, right? Oh, but you got a Timberland boot on your head. Ah! Ah! Damn! He took all the nerves out of my hand.